In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In this Eucharistic celebration, let us pray for the people, those who are affected by coronavirus 19. May the Lord shower His blessings upon them, so that they may recover soon. Let us also pray to God to protect people from this coronavirus 19, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this Eucharistic celebration. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what have I done and in what have I failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Through your obedience of Jesus, your servant and your Son, you raised a fallen world. Free us from sin and bring us the joy that lasts forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 42, verses from 1 to 7. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom I delight. I have put my spirit upon him, and he will bring justice to the nations. He does not shout or raise his voice. Proclamations are not heard in the streets. A broken reed he will not crush, nor will he snuff out the light of the wavering wick. He will make justice appear in truth. He will not waver or be broken until he has established justice on earth. The islands are waiting for his law. Thus says God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread the earth and all that comes from it, who gives life and breath to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you for the sake of justice. I will hold your hand to make you firm. I will make you as a covenant to the people and as a light to the nations, to open eyes that do not see, to free captives from prison, to bring out to light those who sit in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 12, verses 1 to 11. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where he had raised Lazarus, the dead man, to life. Now they gave a dinner for him, and while Martha waited on them, Lazarus sat at the table with Jesus. Then Mary took part of costly perfume made from genuine spikenard and anointed the feet of Jesus, wiping them with her hair, and the whole house was filled with fragrance of perfume. Judas Iscariot, The disciples who was to betray Jesus remarked, "This perfume could have been sold for 300 silver coins and the money given to the poor." Judas indeed had no concern for the poor. He was a thief, and as he held common purse, he used to help him to the funds. But Jesus spoke up, "Leave her alone. Was he not keeping it for the day of the burial?" Many Jews heard Jesus was there, and they came not only because of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priest thought about killing Lazarus as well. So many of the Jews were drifting away because of him and believing in Jesus. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, what is life? For this question, each and every one of us has different answers. What is life? To understand life, we need to go to the three locations. One is hospital, the second one is prison, the third one is cemetery. When you go to hospital, you will understand that nothing is more beautiful than health. Health is wealth. If health is lost, everything is lost. Second, you are supposed to visit prison. You will go to the prison and see the prisoners. There you find what is the meaning of freedom. God has given us freedom for each and every one of us. Let us not misuse our freedom. Let us use our freedom in a responsible way. Thirdly, you go to the cemetery. You will realize that life is worth nothing. The ground we walk today will be the roof tomorrow. Our birth and death is not in our hands. Rest of life is in our hands. So, therefore, let us be so humble. Have a fear of God. Respect human beings. For this wonderful grace, let us pray in this Eucharistic celebration. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God all of creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of the human hands, it will become for us spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of His name, for our good and all the good of all of our church.
Father, in the rising of your Son, death gives birth to new life. The sufferings He endured restored hope to a fallen world. Let sin never ensure with empty promises of passing joy. Make us one with you always, so that our joy may be holy and our love may be a bright light. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, it is our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks through your beloved Son Jesus Christ. He is the Word through whom you made the universe, the Savior you sent to redeem us. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you took flesh and was born of the Virgin Mary. For our sake, He opened His arms on the cross. He put an end to death and revealed the resurrection. In this, He fulfilled your will and won for the holy people. And so we join the angels and the saints in proclaiming your glory as we say,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave his thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When the supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be set for you and for all men, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again.
In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the life-giving bread, the saving cup. Thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in the body and the blood of Christ be brought together in unity of the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love, together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Antony Swami Savarimuthu, and all the clergies. Bring them all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through Jesus Christ, your Son. Let us sing together. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And in your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that I take that you,
you should take.
Let us pray. Lord, may we never fail to praise you for the fullness of life and salvation you give us in this Eucharistic celebration. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.